Hello and welcome. Today I show you how I got packages for components to make a DIY microphone, high quality microphone. This package came from micbooster.com or .co.com. So that's from UK. And this is not a sponsored video. I paid for this regularly. I even made tea and spilled it. Okay, this is not the greatest tea, but it's pretty good for me. I'm drinking tea because I'm unboxing the package from England, so should be unboxing with tea. Okay, so let's have a look at the package. The exciting stuff. There's a really thin envelope with some interesting stamp. I like that he stamps these packages, so it's like saying thank you and details of the seller. It's pretty good. And yeah, this is the website, his website. There I got all the parts and I believe they're original, so let me know if you bought from this website and how you feel about it. I think there are other websites that sell parts.
Oh, they're so small, they're so tiny. Wow. Oh, they're so small.
This is the Primo EM258. And these are 6 millimeters, very tiny. I mean, they're really tiny. These microphone capsules are the same capsules, I'm 99% sure, the same capsules that you find in the LOM Uzi Micro, the plug-in power type. So if you want to make your own high quality microphones, you can get the parts and make them yourself. And the connector 3.5 millimeter jack. This is a brand called Neutrik. It's supposed to be a good one. I mean, the package is really amazing. It has everything, product details. It's even like everything about it, even a diagram to how to install it, which it's a bit difficult for me actually. But they even tell you how to cut the wires. That's amazing. This is really good. So let's see what's inside this package. This is a rubber boot here. It's a strain relief, so the cable doesn't break so easily. And that part is plastic. It's going to screw in the connector to make it secure. And the rest of the pieces, we have, this is the actual connector, the 3.5 millimeter TRS. And the connections are pretty nice here. You can put the one wire through the hole and then solder it. It's a gold plated connector, not silver plated. Silver is better, I heard, but gold plated for me, anything is better than tin, right? So I don't really know how to use this thing, this strain relief. It's supposed to lock here, but I can't find a way to do it. I will try it later anyway. From what I understood, if the cable is more thick than 3 millimeters, I believe, you have to remove that second part and keep only one of them. But okay, I'll try it later. As you heard, that part is metal, so the only plastic components here are the white one and the black one that I'm putting on now, so it's partly metal. That's pretty nice. Here I wasn't able to screw this all the way in and I didn't want to break it, so I left it like this to have a look at it another time. I I'm not sure. You write in the comments if you know about these connectors, if this is good enough. Had a bit of more tea in there. So this is the same thing, just the second connector. I got two basically, so I'm not gonna open this one, it's the same as the previous one. I got also this style of connector. This is what they usually use when they assemble their own microphones. The website sells also the ready-made microphone, and they use this style. So I was curious to try to compare these connectors and see which one is more interesting. The low microphones, they use the previous connector, the previous one, the L-type. That's a bit more convenient and it looks a bit more solid when it's made. Also, because it won't take too much space. Yeah, that's a metal connector. So here the only plastic part is this white thing. I believe this is, you're supposed to put this over the wires so they don't touch the housing, the black housing. So there are no shorts basically between negative and positive, and you have to crimp that connector there. So once you crimp it, it's a bit difficult to change the wire. So yeah, the previous connector was a bit better, but this is not really a big deal. This one is also very good. Also got two of these. The main reason is if you prefer a right angle or a straight connector, this is the main thing. Depends on how you use it.
It's so thin.
This cable is Mogami. It's I read about it, I searched it, I googled it, and it's a really very well-known brand of cables, Mogami. So this is really soft and very thin, and it's, I had to google it to understand what is this. Is unbalanced. It means it has a center core and shielding around it. That means it's two wires. The cable is Mogami 2368 unbalanced miniature cable, the Neutrik 3.5 meter jack stereo connector, and the angle one, and Primo EM258 6 millimeter capsule, omnidirectional. They are omnidirectional, very small, and they are pretty useful in the ultrasonic range. They have an interesting response in ultrasonic range, so that would be nice to try. Very sensitive, and I'm really, really interested to try. Got another package because I wanted a few other things and I forgot to add them before. It was the balance cable Mogami 2697 and the Primo EM172. I wanted to try this 172 also, but this one is a bit, I'm not sure if it's gonna work directly in the normal portable recorder or if it needs to have power. It needs a bit more power than the previous one. Again, his interesting package. Looks like there should be candies or something in this bag. Oh, those are the candies microphones. Yeah, so I got two kinds of cables and the EM172. I got four pieces. They also have the option to pair them to match the strength, but I didn't really care about that much. I could do that myself, I could try to do that. These are pretty large, 10 millimeters. It doesn't sound like a big difference on paper, between 6 and 10 millimeters, but it's almost double. So yeah, those are microphones. And this is the balanced cable. Balanced means it has one shield around two wires, so you can have the signal going through those two middle core wires, and the shield will protect those two wires from the signal. Or you could use this to carry left and right channels. Very flexible, a bit thicker than the other one, but still really flexible. And this is more traditional style, figure 8, two stereo cable, just a regular stereo cable. Still, it would be, it might be useful. I could try to use this, just split it and use it for a stereo microphone, or I would use the other ones as a stereo microphone, or try both. I don't know, I just wanted to add it to have it as an option. So this is the stuff. I will try to make a few stereo microphones, DIY stereo microphones, that will be similar to the Pluggy, they call it Pluggy from micbooster.com, or the LOM Micro USI, the small ones. The LOM USI uses the big capsules here. So yeah, that could work, but I think they will need more power than what is supplied in the plug-in power from the recorder. Let me know in the comments below if you tried these microphones, these capsules, and how they work for you. They're both omnidirectional, so they pick up sound from everywhere. The small ones especially are great for lavalier. You can make a really small microphone, put it in the shirt, it's amazing. The big one, not so much. But the big one is more sensitive, and it has a lower, it gives more voltage for the same signal from outside, so it means the noise is lower. That's really good in theory, but we have to see. Later I will make them and make a few tests. So far it's just a bunch of plastic and metal, and yeah, the cables. Yeah, thanks for watching, and thanks to the guy from this website for not scamming me. Anyway, this is pretty good. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, and share. And I'll see you next time. Bye. Look and down your phone. No, 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 no,